'Twas the night before Christmas when all through the coop, not a chicken was stirring except when they pooped. Most birds were snug roosting on their perches with care, in hopes that St. Chickenmas soon would be there. Some broodies were nestled in broody box beds, while visions of mealworms danced in their heads. With the first man in PJs and I in my robe, I had just settled down to stare at my phone. When out in the chicken yard there arose such a chatter, I sprang up from my bed to see what was the matter. Away out the back door I flew like a flash, tore past the garage and tripped over the trash. My flashlight on straw bales covered in snow gave luster of midday to the objects below. When what to my wondering eyes should appear but a buff bantam silky and 8 tiny Danvers. That little old rooster was so lively and quick, I knew in a moment it must be St. Chick. Much slower than eagles, his Danvers they came, and he cock-a-doodle-dooed and called us by name. Now people, now humans, now house-dwelling creatures, now bipedal mammals with monkey-like features. From the tops of your hearts to the seats of your soul, just stop all your fighting and bring peace to us all. As dry shavings that before the wild winds fly, when they meet with the treetops, mount up to the sky. So up to the coop top the Danvers they flew, with their hearts full of joy, and St. Chickenmas too. And then in a twinkling I heard in the coop the pecking and scratching of each little chook. As I held out my flashlight and crept in with no sound, through the coop window St. Chickenmas came with a bound. He was covered all in fluff from his head to his foot, and his feathers were all tarnished with soil and soot. A bundle of scratch he had flung on his back, and he looked so funny pecking open his pack. His eyes, how they twinkled, his hackles, how merry. His comb was like roses, his wattles like cherries. His quaint little crest was tied up in a bow, and the beard on his chin was so furry and low. He was fuzzy and plump, a right jolly old roo, and I laughed when I saw him, and I know you would too. A wink of his eye and a twist of his head soon made me glad that I jumped out of bed. He squawked not a word, but went straight to his group and scattered their scratch on the floor of the coop. And laying his wing aside of his cheek and giving a nod out the window, he shrieked. He ran through the yard, his Danvers did follow, and away they all flew like some species of swallow. But I heard him exclaim ere he drove out of sight, "Peace on earth for us all, and for all a good night."